and かずこです。なんと今日はかずちゃんがスカイプで一緒にレッスンをしてくれます。
イエーイ。
かずこ from Japan。 かずこはでもカナダにいる
そうね、I'm in Canada。
かっちゃんに英語を助けてもらって、英語に訳しにくいような日本語のレッスン。
So today, again, I'm going to help Tomoko to translate her Japanese into English, and we're going to focus on the Japanese phrases that's hard to translate into English.
それ。今日も3つやりますね。
We picked up three phrases today.
ではまず最初はもったいない。
First one is もったいない。It's a waste. What a waste.
What a waste. これよく使うよね。
We really use it often. もったいない。
で、for example? 例えば、食べ物でもよく使うんだけど、カズちゃんが
I have potato chips and there's still some left, but I justdon't want to eat it anymore, so I'm just gonna throw it away. もうお腹いっぱいなんで捨てようかな。
それもったいない。もったいない。捨てないで、don't throw it away。捨てないでもったいないっていう時に使います。
So、in that case,、if you throw away something,、yeah, same as English, what a waste. So it's a waste. So don't do it.
Don't do it. What a waste. ね、もったいない。あ、他にも、あ、そうそう、才能的なこと。
So that was for food and things. If you waste something, we say もったいない。But also we can use it for talents and our abilities. So for example,
Kazuko can play piano very well. Kazu ちゃんがピアノすごく上手だけど、みんな見たことない。一度も聞いたことない。みんなの前でね、いつも弾かないでいるとかね。そうすると、そのピアノを弾く才能、もったいない。
So for example, if I were able to play piano really, really well and I never play the piano in front of anybody in the public, Tomoko would say me, oh, what a waste, you're wasting your talent. So you can say that in Japanese too, like もったいない。
あとなんか資格、免許を持ってて、
Oh yes, so for example, Tomoko has a yoga instructor certificate and she's not teaching at the moment. So I would say, oh, Tomoko さんもったいないですね。先生の資格持ってるのに。So I would say, oh, you're wasting your... It's what a waste. You can teach, and... but you're not teaching. So, もったいないですね。
そう、そういう使い方をします。もったいない。ね。では、二つ目。
Number two.
こだわり。
じゃあこだわり。So, it can be translated as obsession, preference. Can you explain it, Tomoko?
はい。例えばじゃあ食べ物にこだわる。もうこれを食べないと気が済まない。こればっかり食べちゃうとかっていうときは英語では。例えばヨーグルト、このヨーグルトだけは毎日食べるわって。
So for example, if you're obsessed to one type of yogurt, for example, like you have to have it every day for the breakfast, it's gotta be it. Like it has to be that certain thing. That's your kodawari. That's your obsession to something. So if you're picky about food, so another translation is you're picky about food, or you can say.食べ物にこだわりがある means you're obsessed with food to a certain thing. So yeah, as Tomoko said, if you have to eat certain brands, a certain type of yogurt every day, I have to eat Greek yogurt for the breakfast, that's your こだわり。
そう、こだわりがある。こう、ワイシャツ。ワイシャツなんかも、洗って洗濯ね。I can do laundry, of course, and ironing. But,My husband likes クリーニングって何て言うんだっけ？
クリーニング、クリーニングですよ。
クリーニングにいいの？クリーニングに出したワイシャツが好きだから、 もうこれしか着ない、これじゃないと着ないのよね。
So for example, he, Tomoko's husband, although Tomoko can do her, do the laundry and, do the ironing, but he, her husband likes his shirts to be, cleaned at the proper store, like cleaning store. I think that's a cleaning store, I think. Laundry store.And you know where they can, iron and, put the, iron and there will be no wrinkles on the shirt. So that's his こだわり。So Tomoko さんの旦那さんはシャツにこだわりがある。
そう、こだわりがある。必ずそれ、私が下手なのかな。
Tomoko's wondering if she's bad at ironing. I don't think so. But I mean, it feels nice after you receive clothes, from the store.For example, Tomoko さんのこだわりは何ですか？
私のこだわりっていうのはだって数ある？
まあ、ヘルシーな食生活にこだわってます。化粧品もナチュラルなのに、あ、化粧品もこだわってます。ナチュラルな方がいいです。 So I prefer cosmetics which is more natural. So that's my こだわり。 That's my preference
あのね、でもね、それね、When you getting old, it, no matter, なんだっけ、it doesn't matter じゃないわ。年取るとね、なんでもいいのよ。はい、訳して。
Tomoko said, it doesn't matter whatever you, it doesn't matter what you use when you old, when you get older.
そうね、皆さんはこだわりあるかしら。
そうですね、皆さんのこだわりを教えてください。So what's your obsession?Or what's your preference for certain things? Like something you feel like it has to be this way. Let us know in the comments below.
で、最後にじゃあ3つ目やっとこう、3つ目。は、めんどくさい。
めんどくさい。うん。よく使いますね。
よく使うね。
We all use it often. めんどくさい can be annoying. Not annoying. Or tedious.Or pain the neck, pain the butt.
例えばじゃあ、もう本当今あの大掃除、掃除の時にカーテンを全部こういうので外してまたつけるでしょ。洗ってつけるっていうのはすごいめんどくさい。
そうですね。So Tomoko's cleaning the house for the coming New Year. That's Japanese thing to do.So before the new year comes in Japan, we clean the whole entire house. And Tomoko was saying, so she has to clean up the curtain, so you have to take it off, you have to take all the hooks from the curtain, and then wash it, and then dry it, and then you have to put it back. So that's tedious, めんどくさい。
そういうのめんどくさいは、それは tedious、tedious だよね。なんかめんどくさいことした？
あ、スノボに行ってスノボの準備がめんどくさいですね。
最初
So I went snowboarding and until I get there, like preparation, it's めんどくさい。 It's a pain in the butt or a pain in the neck.
やることもだけど、人に対してもそのペインザネック聞く、こうすぐ泣いちゃう人、すぐ怒る人。
You can use めんどくさい to explain some people. So Tomoko was saying for someone who gets, who cries really quickly or who gets upset really quickly, めんどくさい。So like someone too difficult to deal with or someone that's, hard to interact with, it's めんどくさい。あ、彼女めんどくさいよねとか。
あ、そうそう。Mm-hmm.めんどくさい人。
めんどくさい人。Yeah, like she's a troublesome person. It's めんどくさい人。I feel like 子供 is めんどくさい。
は
I don't like kids. I want kids someday, but I don't like kids in general. I don't know how to deal with them.
まあね、いろいろあるからね。
So please let us know what's your kodawari, if you remember what it is, in the comment below, or maybe something you feel like mendokusai to do. That's fine too, but yeah, let us know in the comments.
はい、お願いしますね。今日も3つの新しい言葉かな?
Yes, so we learned three new phrases today.
はい、かっちゃんありがとう。